Hi there, my name is Daniel, and this is a short review of the Headrush FX Looper Board. I just got it a couple of weeks ago, and I've actually already used it for two different gigs, so I thought that it would be helpful for me as a live looping performer and a singer-songwriter to take a few minutes and tell you what my initial impressions are, just in case you happen to be looking for one as well. So I want to start by first of all asking you if you'll take just 2 seconds to hit the little button down underneath the screen that subscribes you to my channel. And I know you haven't watched the video yet, and this may be the first time you've ever seen me, but I promise you there's going to be lots of other things that I'm going to be doing with this looper that you are going to want to be able to see. So be sure and hit that subscribe button. All right, I guess the easiest place to start is going to be with what I was doing before. And what this unit replaced was a pretty complicated setup. I'll be honest, it was probably way more complicated than it really needed to be for what I was doing. But what I had was my Taylor 114 run into a Yamaha that was a 12-channel mixer that had reverb, and but it also had a group output, and that group output ran to the Boss RC300. Then it ran all the way back from the Boss RC300 back to the mixer, and I had my acoustic guitar, I had my main drum, I even had a cajon, and I had a bass, which, by the way, side note, if you happen to hear some stomping or banging around, I apologize for that. I'm staying in an Airbnb right now, and there's a family with a 2-year-old in the floor above me. Maybe the music will drown me. I don't know. Anyway, getting back to this, part of the reason that I tell you why I was using what I was using live, and it was a decent system, is to give you a point of contrast for just how much the looper board simplifies everything. As I was creating loops, I had my mixer off to the side over here, and so I was checking in and out instruments, muting them and unmuting them. And so I was able to get the sound that I wanted, but it was a lot of button pushing to be able to get there. And the joy of this looper board is that it simplifies it. And basically all I have now in my rig is my guitar, my looper board. And then if the place I'm playing doesn't have a house system, I have my PA system set up. That's it. So let me just tell you about a few things that I like about the looper board, and I think that'll help give you an idea of how I'm using it too. First of all, I love the sound quality of the looper board. It is stellar. I mean, it is markedly better than the Boss RC300. There was always sort of a background hissing noise in my loops, and I had to be really, really careful because it would multiply itself the more loops I made. There's nothing like that in the looper board, and having the extra inputs and being able to control each one, I don't have to worry about any outboard devices adding noise. Everything just runs right into it, and it is as clean as it can possibly be. The next thing I really like about the looper board is the touch screen. And not only does it look cool, but it is sharp, it is bright. I haven't used it outside, but I have no problem whatsoever seeing the stage. And it's nice because it displays the track head in the loop, depending on what display you've got. And so I can see where I am in a loop, and if I want to jump in or out, or how long I've got before I need to start playing, just in a split second in the loops. And likewise, having that, it makes it a lot easier to adjust parameters, like the effects racks and things that I'll talk about more in just a second. Also, just having a keyboard to be able to enter in the names of the loop patches without having to sit there and turn a knob and hit a button and turn a knob through a whole bunch of letters and symbols and numbers to be able to get individual patches in. I honestly never programmed the RC300 with individual patches, but I do this one, and that simplifies things significantly whenever I'm performing. Another thing that simplifies things is foot navigation. That's the third thing I like about it. There are all these buttons on the front, but there is a function button that adds functionality to the buttons that you have. So all of your start and stop and record controls become alternate buttons for turning on effects and clearing tracks and fading tracks and a bunch of stuff that I don't use, like reversing and transposing. And I mean, it's honestly got a bunch of stuff I will probably not use, but it's there, and that makes it flexible and it's all accessible. Even changing what patch you're going to, or what track, or turning the effects racks on and off. You can control that all with your feet. Turning the tuner on and muting everything. You can do most of the things that you need to do in a live performance setting just with your feet. It's also been really nice. Another thing I like about it is to have that fourth track. There are so many songs that I could do differently, or even songs I couldn't do the way I wanted to, because I only had three tracks on the RC300, and depending on how I was using them, I might even just have two to put melodic content in. So having that fourth track really makes a huge difference. I think you'd be surprised at, depending on how you use a looper, at just what a difference it makes, but that's been a nice thing. With that, the recording modes have been a huge simplifier for me. For example, it has the standard modes, like a fixed mode where every track is the same length. It has a serial mode where it plays each track by itself, and you can turn tracks on and off or cue tracks up and sort of do a verse, chorus, bridge thing like that. And then it has the sync mode where you can have tracks of different lengths and be able to run them all at the same time. But the one that's helped me out a lot is the serial sync mode. And what it does is it gives you a sync track. It gives you the first track to record like beatbox or do percussion sounds, and then tracks 2 through 4 act as a serial track system. And so what it lets you do is record your percussion or something that's going to be on every single track, and then have the other tracks work in serial. And this saves a huge amount of time. If you've ever tried to do verse, chorus, bridge type things, and you know you gotta go through each track and do the percussion, well, unless the percussion's different for each part, you just do it once, do a couple bars of it, and then you've got it for the rest of the serial tracks. It saved me a lot of time building loops in songs that I've done for a while now. I mentioned earlier there's some extra features that I think are handy in performing. One of those is the fade feature, and this doesn't sound exciting at first, but sometimes as I'm switching tracks on and off, there, depending on the way it's recorded, might be sort of an abrupt end to it, and I just don't like that. Maybe I've got a song that the chord progression is the same through the verse and the chorus, but I want to bring in extra vocal parts during the chorus, and maybe if I don't hit the button at just the right time, then there's a little bit of hangover there, or if I got a shaker in the background, there's a very sudden and abrupt end when I turn that track off. Well, there's a fade feature, and the way I sometimes use it is to set it at 10%, and that's an almost imperceptible fade, but it just makes that a lot cleaner fade to go out of that track. And so there's other things, reverse, transpose, bounce. You can bounce tracks to one track. So as you've built something, you could get really complex and free up space on tracks while still having what you originally recorded bounced away into another track. I mean, and all that again is accessible by your feet during your performance. Another thing I really like is the ability to send a click track just to my ears. There's a headphone setting on the inputs and the outputs to where I can send a click track to my monitors, but the house does not have the click track, and that has been super handy. I can set it to just play whenever I am recording, and so the click is on while I'm recording. As soon as I stop recording or dubbing, the click goes away, so it's not sitting there clicking in my ear, annoying me the entire time that I'm performing. And that has really helped a lot in tightening up some of my loops. I mean, when you're a one-man band sort of thing, I've got pretty good rhythm, but there's nothing that exposes a rhythm inaccuracy like doing 8 or 12 bars of something and then coming back to it and realizing you were like 5 beats per second off. And I've had that happen a few times. This, I pretty much negate that. I don't have to worry about it anymore because I got the click track right in my ear as I'm performing. The FX racks. There are four FX racks in the effects section, and they have different settings you can use, different styles. One's for voice, one's for guitar, one's for studio type sounds, lo-fi, dubstep, and there's one more that I can't remember, but if you look in the manual, you'll see them. And you don't have to just use the guitar rack with a guitar. You can use it with vocals, or you can use the studio rack with guitar, which is actually what I use. And this has been the single biggest simplifier out of everything, because now my compression, my reverb, my EQ is done within my looper, and so I can send a signal straight to my PA system or to house, and I don't have to worry about carrying a mixer or turning knobs or anything like that. I also have an FX rack set up for my guitar assigned to that input to make it emulate a bass. And so between beatboxing and maybe tapping on my guitar strings or on the top of my guitar and the bass emulation and all the other things that are in there, I can be a one-man band with just my guitar, have all of the effects, have reverb, delays, chorus, all kinds of stuff right there in the box, and I don't have to have it outside. I can also turn those on and off. I can assign foot switches to turn those on and off. And so I can turn the bass sound on, do the bass tracks I need to do, then turn it off and go straight to the guitar sound that I want to. And again, I can do that all with my feet. And that has been a huge gear saver, time saver. It just makes life so much easier to not have to haul a ton of junk. Well, that's not junk, that's good gear I spent money on, but to not have to haul a whole bunch of stuff into a performance setting. Last thing that I really like about it, it's just super flexible. There's all kinds of different ways you can use it, and I just use it one the way that I do and in the style of music that I do, but it's really wide open for however you might want to use it, whether you just do like one microphone vocal looping and do your own beatbox and harmonies and things. You can put the effects in there. You can connect an external MIDI controller and program it to turn certain things on and off or activate different settings and have that there beside the looper, and which is something I've actually thought about doing myself. I'll mention more in just a minute in my gripes. I don't know that I will ever use even half of the capability of this thing, and it has already made things so much easier for me in my performance situations, and just the two that I've used it for. Now some gripes. Wouldn't be complete without having a few things I wish could be different, or maybe a little bit better. The first thing that I did not realize is there is a setting in the global settings that you need to go change if you get this board first thing, and that is by default it is set to reset any settings that you make when you turn the device off. I don't know why. Maybe a firmware update will change that. I have the latest firmware update, I think. I kept setting things up and coming back and realizing they'd been erased. And then I discovered that button. It's in the settings, the global settings. It's the revert to default settings when you turn it off. Make that stop, or you'll get really, really annoyed at this thing. Another one that threw me, which is not a big deal, but you know, at the same time, why? When you're in serial mode, the stop buttons actually cue up the next track. Which doesn't sound like a big deal, except for I'm used to the RC300. When I hit the play button, it will play the next track. Well, to start and stop tracks and things, you have to use the stop button. And the record play dub button, the button labeled as play, doesn't always actually play. It will record or dub. Or if you're in serial mode, and I'm trying not to be confusing here, if you're in serial mode, let's say you're playing on track 3 and you hit the play record button for track two to go back to it. It cues it up, but it cues it up to start recording as soon as it gets to it. Now there's things that you can change in the settings that can alleviate some of that confusion, but nonetheless, having to reach over the play button to cue up a track, I'm getting used to it, but it is a little bit awkward when I'm standing up on one foot playing an acoustic guitar and singing, trying to reach over the row of buttons to be able to cue up the next track or to stop a track or to start a track. So if you're watching Headrush, maybe an option in the settings to flip that to where the buttons for play actually do the playing or the queuing up, or it can be like it is now, and just leave that up to the user as an option. Last thing, and again, this is just, it's not a big deal, but there's no good way to mute things. In my RC300, I had a setup with an extra foot switch where I had three different commands run to one button, and those three commands were to mute or to clear things. And so I could mute my input, and that's really important when you're looping if you've got an open mic. You don't want an open mic or two open mics while you're recording a guitar track because you'll be picking up noise that you don't want. I've built my own mute switch, but I realize not everybody is as technically inclined as I am. And so that's just something to consider if there was a mute option in there, even if it was just in the effects racks. I realize you could do a volume, turn the volume up and down and things like that, but I don't want to waste an effects button on the master volume. I would like to reserve that for effects. So that's just another little gripe, but it's not a huge deal. So overall, very, very happy with this looper, very happy that I made the decision to get it. It is definitely an upgrade over the RC300. Again, it has simplified a lot of things. I also feel like it has opened up my possibilities. I've got a lot of other things now that I will be able to do with it creatively that I was not able to do with the RC300, and I am super excited about those possibilities. So if you're on the fence about it, I highly recommend it. And this is coming from the perspective of a singer, songwriter, and performer. I use it, I have been using it, and will continue to use it. And I would suggest you use it if you've got the cash and you're serious about doing this. Now again, this is not for somebody just getting into looping. If you're doing that, go with one of the Boss pedals or the Ditto looper or the, even Digitech makes a good looper that's just a single track. Just go with one of those and see. That's where I started out. Make sure it's what you want to do. But if you're into building songs or doing stuff that's a lot more complex, then this will definitely help you out. The only place I could think of to go after this would be to go into an Ableton setup. But I really think there's a lot for most people just in this one box that they wouldn't even need to think about doing that. So if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. Again, thank you for watching. If this was helpful for you, hit the subscribe button down here, and I'll have some more tutorials and things coming up in the future, how I use the looper, some shortcuts I've found, some things that can help you out as you are getting into doing all of this. So have a great day, and I'll chat with you more later.